Hello, it's Debbie here, and today I thought I'd include a video which shows how, when exploring a new technique or medium, to expect that things won't go right, but to keep pushing on, learning more, and having fun while doing so. One person's work I turn to when I think of mixed media effects I like is Tiffany Solorio. She creates projects which have a lovely light ethereal feel with occasional pops of colour. I watched one of Tiffany's tutorials on creating a lovely tag, I'll link that video below, and this led to my experiments today. I started with a piece of Fabriano watercolour card and a new-to-me Tim Holtz Distress Mixed Media Heavy Stock. I wanted to compare how these took the distress media I gathered to use. I picked a colour scheme of speckled egg, antique linen and black soot. This blue, cream, black combination is one I've used on a few cards and like the end results. I began by spritzing the card with water and then bringing in speckled egg distress spray stain, followed by antique linen distress spray stain. It became quickly obvious that the watercolour card warped significantly with all the water being added to it. Normally I'd take watercolour card to a board, but because of the techniques I wanted to use today, that wasn't an option. I was pleasantly surprised to see that the mixed media heavy stock pretty much stayed flat. There are other differences too. The media absorbs into the surface of the watercolour card, whereas it stayed on the surface of the distress card more, which enabled me to play around with the media better. My mistake with these two pieces is that I kept adding and adding colour and pretty much ended up with mud. I wasn't feeling the right vibe. I think that all too often we see the highlight reel of a creative project. It is all too easy to cut out the bits that didn't work when editing a video, but I think sharing this learning process helps others to see that the cards we share aren't made in the space of 10-minute video. My cards often take me hours to make, watercolouring takes time, things don't work and I start again. Occasionally I think it's a good reminder to see the full process. I put these two pieces I didn't like to one side and I started again, this time with just the distress card as it had worked better in my first attempt, but this time I kept a lighter hand until I added black soot splatter and then spritzed that splatter. Black soot is such a powerful colour and dominated the layers underneath. I was back to mud again. So I started again with a light hand with a speckled egg and antique linen, but this time trying to keep more white space, open areas with dribbles of colour weaving through them. I turned to something I know I like and with a base layer of colour down I started to add splatter. Splatter of the speckled egg and antique linen, splatter of black soot while making sure not to spritz that and moved around too much. White gouache splatter too, of course. This background started to feel a little more like me. I used a whole piece of A4 distress card when creating this background and I did this for a reason. I wanted lots of movement and that's easier for me on a larger surface, and then I cut the piece into quarters. I picked my favourite of the four pieces which had a concentration of colour in one corner leading down to open space. I can use the other pieces another time. I took this panel and used the painted flowers wreath stencil along with distress inks in antique linen, speckled egg and black soot. I kept the blue over the flowers, the cream over the foliage and then brought in light touches of black soot to add contrast. The effect is subtle but I liked it, and to help it blend in I added more splatter over the top with white gouache and black soot. Keeping with the distress line, I used black soot distress oxide ink on the friendship text background. I liked how the text fades on one side. I rolled the stamp over the card to get a partial image. As I lifted the stamp, I realised I had the text upside down. And so I rotated my card and the main elements were now going to be bottom left rather than top right. To add texture and another layer to this background, I reached for Tim Holtz Crackle Texture Paste and using a palette knife smeared it over the background in a few places. My tub of crackle paste is starting to run out and the paste I used was a little dry. However, I think this meant I got even greater crackle when I dried it with a heat tool. To emphasise the texture more, I first brought in frayed burlap distress ink and rubbed it into the crackle paste cracks. Then I reached for the big guns and added touches of walnut stain distress ink. This has a much deeper, richer colour, and I had to be careful not to overdo it. I had no plan for this card. I was experimenting and seeing where I ended up. The focal point of this card was now bottom left of the panel, and so I thought the garden gate die would make a good layer to add. I die cut the die from ivory card, trimmed out just one gate from the die cut, and lightly mushed it into antique linen distress space stain so the gate wouldn't be too clean and stark against the background. I used Gina K Connect glue to adhere the piece to the panel. Tiffany uses vellum layers in her projects, and so I stamped the Thoughtful Flower wood stamp in clear embossing ink on vellum, sprinkled with white embossing powder and heat set before trimming out. I'm still enjoying using these Tim Holtz Dymo inspired labels. I wanted to foam mount this one on my card, and so I cancelled out the adhesive on the back with anti-static powder before adding foam tape. Before I added these elements to the panel, I wasn't quite done yet. I trimmed the panel down to be just slightly smaller than an A2 card base, and then I added a piece of torn old book paper. I glued this in place and then blended it into the pieces with, you guessed it, more splatter. I then used foam tape on the label to hold the vellum flower in place on the card front. I added the panel to a card base cut and scored from ivory card, and then finished off with a few duck egg nouveau droplets and little things from Lucy's Cards eggshell pearls. I did go back in and straighten the sentiment label slightly before taking photos. I really should keep a T-square ruler strapped to my side at all times. And so there you have it, another experiment in mixed media where I didn't hold back sharing any of the process it took me to get to this finished card, mistakes and all. I highly encourage you to check out Tiffany's work. She really is amazing. Okay, I'll leave you here for today, but I hope you'll join me again soon as I have lots in store for you next week. I'll leave links to Tiffany as well as links to my blog post where you'll find more details about this card. I'll also leave links below to the products I used today. I really appreciate when you use my links as that means I can continue to provide inspiration moving forward. Thanks for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed this realistic look at creating a card while trying out new techniques. If you want to see more, then please consider subscribing to this channel. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.